My name is Leander Goor. I'm the general manager of Allinq Insite, and we provide scan to BIM services for mainly big utility companies, but also we do the airport of Schiphol, and we're big in the energy industry in the Netherlands. I came here today to get a sneak peek of what you guys were up to. Got introduced to a new scanner. It looks very promising. I saw some sample data. I also got to hold the scanner itself, which was a fun experience. I really like the form factor of it, but also I really like the data. The data of the point density is really great. We are testing, or we have tested a lot of handheld scanners. And the biggest problem was the spaghetti-like point density or LiDAR data we got out of it. We need to model. And if we have a spaghetti-like point cloud, the modeler needs to do a lot of assumptions. Always the modeler needs to do some assumptions when they're modeling, because you always have blind spots. But with the spaghetti data, it's just not good enough for LOD 200, let alone LOD 300 models. When I saw the demo data or the beta data that was presented today, I was like, okay, this is really impressive, because the point density was really good. And there was a rooftop scan, for example. Normally, if you have highly reflective or very dark pitched objects, it's very difficult to capture that good on with, well, LiDAR technology. This was perfect. NavVis is a software company that provides tools to capture the data. And I see the new handheld scanner as a extra tool in the toolbox that we can use for a specific project. I still think that the majority of our project will be scanned with the VLX2 and the VLX3. But for example, if you need to be in the ceilings or in crawl spaces or in any other tight space, we'll probably use the new mobile scanner. And there are benefits for it. And I think there are even more benefits for the scan operator, and I hope there are not a lot of drawbacks for the modelers. So I'm really hoping to test it out and that we can see not only how it scans, but also how we can model with it, because that's what we're actually doing.